Greetings Guardians, my name is Bife here. Yesterday I did a video about how elemental primaries are no longer going to be dropping from the raid and how this is going to change the game. One of the major points that I stumbled across was simply the fact that there will be a lot more weapon variety when it comes to your primary slot. It's no longer going to be filled by just one legendary. With that in mind, I wanted to go over all of the weapons that I thought really were the top tier guns for PvE. These include a lot of exotics, some legendaries, some raid weapons, some weapons that you can acquire from the gunsmith, etc. There's a whole variety of different sources for these, so without much further ado, let's jump in. First of all, take a look at the Vanity. The Vanity is a future war cult hand cannon, and I think personally this is going to be something that speaks to those of you who loved your Fatebringers. It has the Firefly perk, and it's a hand cannon with practically speaking the same ratio of rate of fire and impact. However, it does also get luck in the chamber, adding a little bit of bonus damage and meaning it's somewhat viable in PvP. There's going to be a lot of arguments to be made for using these weapons, however, for all of the hand cannons on this list, one consistent argument is going to be about ammo. I don't recommend the Vanity as often simply because the ammunition supply tends to run dry on some instances, and that can tend to hamper you in your PvE performance. Keep that in mind. Next up, I'm going to talk about Tlaloc, Ace of Spades, and Fabian Strategy, aka all of the gunsmith weapons that you get for rank 3. Doesn't matter what class you are, the gunsmith has an amazing PvE weapon for you. It's been described by so many other YouTubers, and myself as well, as quite simply weapons that will kill stuff quickly in PvE. They are workhorses, to use the exact phrasing of Datto. These particular weapons are definitely going to be something that you should use if you just want to kill stuff quickly. They're not going to be the most amazing exotics with the most amazing effects, and they're definitely not specialized towards anything other than just killing dudes quickly, but it's definitely something you shouldn't shy away from. Fabian Strategy increases its fire rate, although I think that is somewhat bugged at this point. Ace of Spades will allow you to continuously explosively kill smaller minions of the darkness, dealing damage to other enemies around them, and Tlaloc is going to be a beast for Sunsingers that won't be using their super often. So, it's definitely going to be the case that these weapons are ones to watch. Next up, Touch of Malice. Yeah, this one's a bit of an odd recommendation on the list, but it does make it simply because of the fact that the damage that you get when you are in the overcharged mode, it's definitely worth considering. This thing does double the damage, and the headshot multiplier looks even more fearsome when you have this active. So, take that into account. It will be able to kill small groups of enemies really quickly, and the Touch of Mercy effect that you get means you only need to kill 3 people to stop yourself from dying. However, it's not higher on the list simply because of that effect. The life force stealing effect that it has means that sometimes you're going to find yourself dead in the mud when really you should be up there destroying stuff with your fireteam. It's a risky weapon to use, but the high damage sometimes makes it worth it. Next up comes the Smite of Moraine. Yeah, this is a legendary pulse rifle, it's a raid weapon, and it's not the greatest in the world, but frankly, this comes with some really good perks. Life support tends to proc a lot when you get it on this weapon, and sometimes you can get it with Firefly. Not to mention that out of all the raid weapons, I feel like this is just my preference. Yeah, a lot of people do like to use their other weapons. I see a few people who specialize in using Zauli's Bane only, which makes me feel a little bit weird. And there are also some people who are seriously in love with the Doom of Chelchis, the scout rifle. However, as far as I'm concerned, the Smite of Moraine is just the most versatile of any of the primaries. It works the best, and it's got an amazing set of stats to go with it. The only real downside to this weapon is the fact that it's got kind of weird stability. It's not great on that front, but you've got so much ammo in your mag that I don't think it really matters. And the reloads aren't the most painful thing in the world either, especially when you're standing inside an aura. So, yeah, go ahead, feel free to use this weapon. And of course, it's a legendary, unlike quite a lot of the things on this list. Next up comes Bad Juju. Need I say more than the fact that this weapon is a beast? It will literally consume your enemies and then give you free ammunition back. This is amazing versus small targets for sure, not only because it has full auto, but because the perk that you get, known as String of Curses, will allow you to just eat them up, increase the amount of super energy you get, and then also increases your damage. The fact that this weapon even got a buff to its magazine size when the 2.0 update came in makes it even better as a PvE primary. This allows you to turn your class, whatever you're using, into basically a massive super machine. Of course, it allows you to kill a lot of small adds in the way, but it will also let you regen your super so quickly that you can specialize your role much more easily. For example, I tend to run Stormcaller a lot in PvE, and as a result, I use Bad Juju. It means that I can go ahead, clear a lot of adds with my Bad Juju, and then turn around and start using all of the stuff that I've built up for my super in order to decimate yet more small enemies. It's not the greatest versus boss DPS, but it does give me a specialized role. Bad juju lets you get more out of your super, and that's why it's on this list. Next up comes Hawk Moon. Yep, this is quite frankly the best hand cannon in the game if you're going to go PvE. Yeah, there's definitely an argument to be made for Ace of Spades, but when it comes to boss DPS, Hawk Moon is up there, there's no question about it. The problem that tends to happen to hand cannons is that their range has been nerfed, and Hawk Moon has some upgrades that help you to combat this. Not to mention, the lucky rounds that you get are better for boss DPS than anything on any other hand cannon in the game. So, why is this thing not so good? It's simply a case of range and ammo again. Hawk Moon, being a hand cannon that does so much damage, will put it up there, and it's definitely great for that fact, but you can't necessarily control the damage due to the random effects, and you can also lose out on some of the damage when you reload. That's the nature of the luck in the chamber and holding aces perks, you can't necessarily proc the damage when you want. However, it's still really reasonable, so I recommend going ahead and using this whenever you have a decent opportunity, but there are better weapons out there. Next up comes a personal favourite, the Red Death. This is not just a PvP exotic as some people see it, this is definitely a PvE one now. 30 rounds in the magazine means that you get a humongous number of rounds to work with, but also you get the bonus of the obvious Red Death perk, reloading faster and regenerating your health. Two bonuses that can't be underestimated in PvE either. If you simply kill one small ad, you can regenerate your entire health bar very quickly. There's no question in my mind, that makes it worthy. And also the fact that it does damage. Red Death is not some primary that you use simply for regenerating health. Red Death in a lot of ways is like Touch of Malice, but better. The only problem with it, of course, is that sometimes it doesn't do the highest amount of damage. You will have other primaries out there, such as, say, Hawk Moon, that may be capable of higher damage output, but Red Death's consistency and the ability of it to keep you alive in those hairy combat situations makes it worth it. Plus, let's not forget, Red Death also gets high caliber rounds, which means that one single burst will stagger almost any enemy. Definitely worth keeping around just for that fact too, because it will keep you alive even longer for a different reason. Next up, let's talk about what I think is probably the best auto rifle in the game for PvE, the Zalo Supercell. Now, it's pretty simple. This was kind of an odd one between that and Fabian's strategy, and Fabian will probably have more damage output when it does actually get buffed up again. The reason for Zalo being higher is this. Not only does it chain between enemies, but also it's the only arc damage primary weapon that's ever going to come to Taken King. Yeah, that's pretty big. Legendaries are no longer going to have elemental damage, as I said at the beginning of the video. So, as a result, Zalo Supercell and any exotic primary that does some element of damage in the future are going to be so much more valuable. Zalo is a standout from the list, and in most cases for PvE, it's still not that great in terms of its damage output, but when an arc burn week comes, or when you're facing up against a lot of enemies with arc shields, such as, say, Taken Centurions and Fallen Captains, you're going to find that this weapon does some serious work against them, and that means it's got a unique property that most other exotics and legendaries in the game do not have. That puts it at our number 3 slot, as far as I'm concerned. So what's our number 2? This was a kind of a tricky one. But me, I personally feel like this has to go to Jade Rabbit. This is kind of an interesting point to make as well, seeing as Jade Rabbit is an exclusive. Yeah, it's pretty much the case that people on Xbox won't be able to get this for another year, I know, but Jade Rabbit still has such amazing performance that I couldn't leave it out of the list. You can shoot practically an entire clip of ammunition into the enemy's body, shoot them once in the head, and the entire clip will regenerate. That's a very powerful perk, not to mention the fact that it will do more damage according to how many body shots you've made. As a result, this thing becomes a boss slaying machine, and there's no question that it's also great against smaller PvE enemies. It has really high impact rounds. So, when you're using the Jade Rabbit, you can go ahead, shoot enemies that are really far away, simply because of its also very high range, and you can probably either stag them because of the amount of damage that you're doing, or you can simply one-hit kill them with a headshot. It's almost like a sniper rifle in your primary slot, although, let's be honest, it's no land beyond. Either way, this is definitely a weapon worth considering for either boss DPS, or simply if you're trying to find something good to deal a lot of damage. The magazine being so small because of the way that the Fate of All Fools perk on it works, doesn't even factor in. It becomes a weapon worth using despite one of its worst traits. And the reload is really fast anyway, so why complain? This is definitely one to pick up. Finally, this is a personal opinion, but I feel like there is a best weapon out there. And maybe this is just me, but it has a whole bunch of different factors that make it good. I'm choosing the Hung Jury, and there's good reasons for it. First of all, it's a legendary and not an exotic. You can free yourself up to use a sword, sleeper simulant, whatever exotic you want in your special weapon slot, and it doesn't even hamper you that much. But also, the Hung Jury that you get from the Dead Orbit vendor comes with a whole bunch of perks. You can go ahead and grab this thing, and you will immediately have a roll that has Triple Tap and Firefly, Extended Mag, and Braced Frame. All of these are excellent upgrades that you can use, and there's no question in my mind, this makes it one of the most usable scout rifles in the game. You can either get 16 or 20 rounds in the magazine, and Triple Tap will increase that whenever you get 3 headshots in quick succession, and those don't have to be headshot kills either. You can use this against a boss and increase your magazine subtly. Every third shot essentially never happened, although you still deal the damage. That's definitely worth using. The Firefly effect on it, though, is definitely something to take into account as well, because in a small group of ads, that's going to cause havoc, and I mean serious havoc. This thing won't run out of ammo easily because it's a scout rifle, it does decent damage because of the ratio of its rate of fire to impact. It doesn't necessarily stagger people a lot, but that's practically speaking the only bad thing that I can find about it. Yeah, it doesn't have the exceptional damage output of a lot of the weapons out there, but ultimately, in a primary weapon, I'm looking for consistency. And this has consistency, but it throws in a lot of good perks on top. Triple Tap is amazing versus bosses and small targets alike. Firefly is excellent for clearing out small adds. The weapon itself is capable of really snappy reloads, and everything that I see in this weapon just makes me want to use it more. It even has great scopes. This is probably your best bet if you're looking for a good primary in PvE. Pick it up from Dead Orbit. No question. Do it. Do it now. Anyway, that's my list as far as it goes. I hope you guys have good opinions on this because I want to get yours. I want to see if you agree or disagree with me. What weapons do you think I've missed out from that list? Do you reckon there's some things in there that you disagree with? Are there some other weapons that you think should have been on the list but aren't? Also, guys, I need to give a huge thank you to Destiny Overwatch, who got me some of the footage that I used in this video. You can see a link to his channel down in the description below, as well as a few of the videos that he's made. In the meantime, though, if you enjoyed the video, please go ahead and drop a like, and if you want more Destiny content, feel free to subscribe. But my name has been, my name is Bife. Prodacia Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.